Spaghetti straps dress. Please load an avatar from the female V2 folder in the library. Use the Line avatar tool in the 3D toolbar and draw lines onto the avatar. Holding Control will allow you to add curve points instead of segment points. After the shape on the avatar is closed, use the Flatten tool to extract the pattern. Delete any unnecessary curve points and modify the remaining curve points to make the curve smooth. Control D to make a symmetrical pattern, and then Shift F to show arrangement points for arranging the patterns. We can delete the line on the avatar by using Edit Line Avatar. Lengthen the pattern to cover avatar's body. When selecting a pattern, you can use the Marquee box to scale and rotate. Based on the silhouette of the avatar, modify the pattern's curve. Use the Rectangle tool to create the back pattern. Modify the width by moving the pattern outline or points. Control D to make a symmetric pattern. When moving a segment or a point, you can right-click to input a specific distance in the pop-up window. Use Edit Curve Point to adjust the curve of the back pattern. Measure the side seam line of the front and back patterns to ensure the length is the same. Shift F to show arrangement points for arranging the patterns. After selecting the arranged pattern, you can modify its position using Arrangement in the Property Editor. Use the Segment Sewing tool to sew the patterns together. Sew the center back. Select the Pin Box tool and double-click on a point to add pins for a segment. This will make it won't be slipped downward. After measuring the length of the segment where the strap should be sewn, we can use the Rectangle tool to make strap. Control D to make a symmetrical pattern. Shift F to show arrangement points to arrange the pattern. Use the Segment Sewing tool to sew the patterns together. Ensure the sewing notches, or directions, match. We can select the Free Sewing tool in the 3D toolbar and sew in the 3D window. Hold the W key and click on the pattern in 3D window to add a pin. For the small pattern, the mesh count is low, so we can lower the particle distance to get a higher polygon count. This will achieve a smoother appearance. We are going to change the linked editing mode from symmetric pattern with sewing to symmetric pattern, so we can modify the sewing lines on the pattern separately. We can still edit the pattern symmetrically, adding internal lines, for example. But the sewing lines are not symmetrical. Hold the W key and click on Pins to delete them, or use Ctrl W to delete all pins. We can see a gap between the dress and the avatar. To remove the gap, set the skin offset millimeter to 0 and lower the add thickness collision millimeters to 1. Now the pattern is closer to the surface of the avatar. We can use pins to fix the strap. Select the center front and apply 100% elastic to maintain the length of the segment. And apply 100% elastic to the strap. Use the Edit Curve point to edit the curves. We can extend trim the internal line to pattern outline. As the strap is too tight, the front and back patterns are stretched, so we need to lengthen the strap. Use the Edit Sewing tool to move sewing line. We can assign a new fabric to the strap. Here we can use trim, full, grain, leather, and increase the friction and internal damping. We don't want the strap to stretch and slip down. This preset is able to maintain the original shape of the pattern. There are many wrinkles on the back pattern. We can shorten the width of it. To remove the wrinkles, we can add a dart on the back pattern. Use the marquee box to adjust the size and position. Use the segment sewing tool to sew the dart. Copy and paste the front pattern and reset 3D arrangement selected. We are now going to make the ruffles. Select the segment and use Offset Pattern Outline in the right-click menu. It will extend along the side curve if you change the Side Segment Type to Extend and check Create Internal Line. Cut using the internal line and delete the unnecessary parts and curve points. We can use the Edit Curvature tool to modify the curve. Oriented top to bottom, the width of the ruffles is from short to long. Uncheck Elastic on the pattern. The length of the ruffles should be longer than the front and back pattern, so that you can create wrinkles. Use the segment sewing tool or free sewing tool to sew the patterns together. To avoid simulation instability, we need to freeze the dress. Use Superimpose Side to arrange the ruffles to the side of the sewing line. Modify the length and curve of the ruffles. When the dress is stable, we can activate the frozen pattern and simulate. Control D to make a symmetric pattern. We can deactivate the left part of the pattern and Shift Q to hide the selected pattern. Use free sewing to sew the ruffles and dress together. Shift-C, Show Hidden Patterns. Now we can freeze the selected pattern and apply a layer value of 1. This will identify which pattern should be on the outside. Activate the back patterns. To avoid it dropping, add pins to hold it in place in the 3D window. Once the desired draping is achieved, set the layer value back to 0 for more stable simulation. Sew the center back of the ruffles. Use the rectangle tool to create the waistband and Shift F to show arrangement points for arranging the pattern. We can modify its position by using arrangement in the property editor. Freeze all patterns except for the waistband. Apply a layer value of 1 to the waistband. The waistband should be outside of the dress. We can use the Select Mesh tool to select part of a mesh, selected mesh. We can now use the gizmo to move it in the 3D window. Set the layer value back to 0 for a more stable simulation. Before simulating, I will assign the fabric, which we created to the trim full grain leather preset. Lower the shrinkage weft to 50%. The waistband will tighten. Please load a ribbon from Hardware and Trims, Ribbon in the Library window. Click the Scale button to resize the trims and use glue to fix the trims to the waistband. Please notice that trims have weight, so we need to modify the weight in the property editor, lower the particle distance to get to see finer details. If you want to remove the wrinkles on the back pattern, you can use the Steam tool and set a negative shrinkage value.